This video is about simply supported beams. Let us see the SFD and BMD of simply supported beams. Simply supported beam, case number 1. Simply supported beam with a concentrated load P at its midspan. So P is acting at midspan, L by 2, the span. Here is the A point, here let us take it as B point. Considering equilibrium, so in the equilibrium condition, reaction at A, reaction at B will be half of this load on this side, half of this load on this side. Means P by 2 will be acting at reaction A, P by 2 acting at reaction B. Now considering any cross section XX, which is at a distance from left end A, and section YY at a distance from left end A as shown in the figure below. So we have a figure below. So first, shear force in the region, 0 to L by 2. So X is varying between 0 to L by 2. So let us take this part in this format, that is Vx is equals to Ra, which is positive, it is constant now, plus P by 2 in the region of L by 2 to L, means from this center point to towards right point. From 0 to L by 2 is here and L by 2 to L is up to here. So Vx will be Ra minus P, means Ra from left side when we are moving, it is going upwards, reaction is going upwards, P is coming downwards. So Ra is P by 2 and P is coming downwards. So P by 2 minus P is again minus P by 2, means we are getting a negative sign. And again it is constant because there is no loads from end point to center point. Only one point load is there at the center point. So as considering, now bending moment in the region 0 to L by 2, M about any X distance, P by 2. What is P by 2? Ra into X. Its variation is linear. At X is equals to 0, Mx equals to 0. And at X equals to L by 2, Mx is equals to P L by 4. So whatever the X distance we are adding into this equation, so it will become as P by 2 into L by 2, that is totally as P L by 4 is the maximum. Then the bending moment maximum will be P L by 4. At X is equals to L by 2, that is midspan. In the region of L by 2 to L, Mx is equals to Px into X minus P into X minus L by 2, into X minus L by 2. X is the region beyond L by 2 and less than L, and L by 2 is the distance what we have to deduct. So it will coming as PL by 2 minus P by 2 into X, it is variation again linear. At X equals to L by 2, P M max is equals to L by 4, and at X equals to L, M max is equal to 0. So when we draw this interpolations of SFD and BMD, this will be in this formation. So X is varying once from A point to less than L by 2, once again X again is varying from L from X to continue L by 2. This part is going to continue in the next sections. So here it will be going, this part is the shear force. So here we can see the reaction plus P by 2 is going upwards, then P is coming downwards, so it is minus P by 2, again constant. Here again P by 2 is acting in upward direction, that is P by 2. The shear force is make a 0 point at X axis. So bending moment going is 0 here, as we have seen here, X equals to 0, Mx equals to 0. X equals to L by 2, Mx is equals to PL by 4. It is the maximum bending moment diagram. Then coming downward in the force when in the point B, means at the support B, it is again M about L, X is equals to L and Mx equals to 0. Case number 2. Simply supported beam with a concentrated load is not at its midspan. It is not at its midspan. So this is not in the midspan direction. It is somewhere else at a distance of A from A point and B from B point. So we can see in this figure. So considering equilibrium, we get RA, reaction at A point, and reaction at B point. Reaction at A point is PB by L, and reaction at B point is known as PA by L. So considering any cross section XX which is at a distance X from left end, and A, another section YY at a distance X from end A as shown in the figure below. So let us considering that shear force is varying the range between 0 to X, then Vx is equals to RA plus PB by L, it is constant, in the range of A X to L, then RA minus P, again minus of PA by L, it is constant. Bending moment in the range of 0 to A, that is MX is equals to plus RA, reaction at A into X. What is reaction at A? PB by L. And at X is equals to 0, MX equals to 0. And at X equals to A, MX equals to PA by L. In the range of A varying from L, A to L, X is varying between A and L. MX is equals to RA into X minus P into bracket X minus A. So substituting the value, RA value is PB by L, X as it is minus P into X is added plus P into A. Placing B equal to L minus A. Placing B is equals to L minus A. So equal to P into A into bracket 1 minus PA into 1 minus X upon L will be the value of this part. Means we are taking PA as the common part. At X equal to A, MX PAB by L, and at X equal to L, MX equal to 0. So here are the two conditions, two values, one at X equals to A, both are semi, and one at X equal to L, MX equal to 0. So starting is 0, end is 0. At X equals to A distance, PAB by L, PAB by L is the moment acting in both the conditions. This is the first condition where X lies between 0 to A, second is X lies between A to L. So bending moment diagram is somewhat in this figure and shear force diagram. So first X range, this is second X range. This is the reaction at A, reaction at B. Case number 3. Simply supported beam with UDL throughout its length. So UDL is acting throughout its length. We can say this as reaction A, reaction B. So we will be solving this problem by two alternative methods, but I am using only one by the method of sections, which will be very easy for us because the another method is integration method. Okay, here equating with the forces directions, we can easily calculate the bending moments. Considering equilibrium, we get RA is equals to this W into L. We will convert this UDL into point load, which is acting in the midspan, that is WL. Half of this in this side, half of this of forces on this side. So half is W into L divided by 2. Similar to that, here also RB WL divided by 2. Now consider any cross section XX which is at a distance X from left end A. Left end A we are going to consider. So left end A we have to consider. So in this direction, left end is for this way. We can consider the left end from this direction, which will be acting for your side, means I used to say that it is coming from the L point frame, means on this point from here, from left end towards this way it is going to act. Then the section view will be in this format. So we are going to see the section. So section at XX will be somewhat like this. So reaction at A is WL by 2, it is going upwards, okay. Then this W is coming in the downward direction, it is coming in the downward direction. Here we will get that here this arrow is showing that it will come in the downward direction, that is Vx is in the downward direction. And anti-clockwise rotation, Mx is acting here in anti-clockwise direction. So it is moment about x axis which is acting in the anti-clockwise direction. Shear force will be WL by 2 minus W into x, that is shear force varies linearly at x equals to Vx as WL by 2, at x equals to L by 2 Vx equals to 0, at x equals to L WL by 2 will be in minus sign. Then bending moment is equals to Mx equals to WL by 2 into x minus Wx square by 2. Then bending moment variation is parabolic. We have to see so how this bending moment is going to get a parabolic, and this is the shear force diagram which we are going to see. So at x equals to 0 means at x equals to 0, what is the shear force? WL by 2. We can see same. So when it comes at L by 2, here somewhere at x equals to L by 2 we are considering. Vx equals to what? It is 0. At x equals to L, Vx is equals to minus WL by 2. So here the load is coming in the downward direction, it is acting. And this point is nothing else. Here the where shear force is getting 0, the maximum moment is going to act at that particular point. Bending moment Mx equals to WL by 2 into x minus Wx bar x square by 2. That is bending moment variation is parabolic at x equals to 0, Mx equals to 0, at L equal to 0, ML equal to 0. Now we have to determine the maximum bending moment which is at the midsection. So this is the maximum bending moment, that differentiating Mx upon dx equals to 0, Vx is equals to 0. So because d upon Mx into dx is equals to Vx, or WL by 2 minus Wx equals to 0, or x by equal to L by 2. Therefore, maximum bending moment will be equals to WL square by 8 at x L by 2, x equals to L by 2, that time it will be maximum WL square by 8. Fourth number case, a simply supported beam with a UVL gradually varying load 0 at one end and unit weight for length over the other span. So this is considering the equilibrium of the beam, that is area of the rectangle, a triangle, half base into height, half base is the weight and the height is now for them as L, acting at a point C at a distance of 2/3 of L by 3 from the left end, means from this A point it is at 2/3 and from B point it is at 1/3. So summation M about B is equals to 0. We are going to have a moment rotation about this. RA is in clockwise rotation, RA is in clockwise rotation. Then this whole load is acting in the leftwards negative sign direction. So RL means RA into L minus WL by 2 into L by 3 equals to 0, or RA is equals to WL by 6. Similarly, sigma MA equals to 0 and RB will give us as WL by 3 is the equation what we are able to see it at this particular point. The free body diagram of a section AA as shown below, load at the center section XX, WX equals to W into X divided by L you can write. So here we can write it as WX by L or W into X by L. So this condition we are considering where our reaction is acting WL by X, and now we are considering some of the similar kind of X axis in the particular member and finding out its moment. So moment is going to come in the action of anticlockwise, because we are having a rotation of the load on the left hand side as anticlockwise rotation. So that is the most important problem what we have to consider. The result of the part of the distributed load which acts on is this free body is half x WL by x, so WX square by 2L applied at Z point distance x by 3 from xx action. So from this end it is at x by 3. Then shear force will be coming as Ra minus Wx square by 2L, which is equals to WL by 6 minus W square by 2L. So therefore the variation of the shear force is parabolic. At x equals to Vx is WL by 6, and at x equals to L, Vx is equals to minus WL by 3. So this is the equation of shear force. Bending moment is we are having as M equx equals to WL by 6 multiplied by minus WX square by 2L into X by 3 equals to W into L divided by 6 into minus of WX cube by L minus 6L. So the variation of bending moment is cubic. At X equals to 0, bending moment is 0. At X equals to L, maximum bending moment is equals to 0. So particularly that when we consider for maximum bending moment, differentiation is the only one step which will be the part of getting answers. So there we are going to substitute the values into the equation. Equation is what? WL upon 6 minus WX square upon 2L equal to 0. So X is what now? L divided by root of 3. And maximum when we are calculating for this, it will come as the particular value of WL square by 9 cube of 3. This is the value of the maximum bending moment which will be occurring at this particular point, and this is the point of the shear force changing its direction, and the particular figure of the question figure which is here. So here we can see this is WL by 6 and this is minus WL by 3. Whole as we can consider the bending moment as WL square by 9 cubic root 3. So case number 5, a simply supported beam with a gradually varying load each 0 at each end and W per unit length is at the midspan. So we have seen so many types. Now this is one more type where the forces are maximum at the midspan and forces are let at the edge points of the figure. So considering the equilibrium of the beam AB, total AB on the B, 2 into 2 and a half into L by 2 into W is equals to W into L by 2 itself only. Then comes the, therefore the reaction RA and RB WL by 4. The free body diagram of section A to XX is as shown in below. So load of a section XX, WX is equals to 2W divided by L into X. So we can see this is the part of the figure what we have considered for the rotationals. So A point, so WL by 4 is rotating in clockwise, anti-clockwise is rotating in this direction, and the shear force is not going to jump more. So this is particular acceleration we are going to consider. Here it is WL by 4. So half of the section is L by 2 here itself only. So resultant part of the distributed load which acts on the free body diagram is half into X into 2 times W by L into X, which is W X square by L. Applied at a point, distance x by 3 from section AA, x by 3 from section AF. So from this distance on this direction, on this side, it is at a distance of x by 3. What is value of that? WX square by L. Shear force in the region 0 to L by 2, Vx is equals to this value we have to substitute. And therefore, we get at x equals to 0, WL by 4, at x is equals to L by 4, which is equals to 0. So, similarly, for the region of 2, the semistar, the particular at x equals to 0, Vx is equals to WL by 4. At x equals to L by 4 is Vx is equals to 0. In the region of L by 2 to L, the diagram will be of the mirror image of AC. So, we are able to see that particular part. So, whatever the mirror image will be here, the same will be in the mirror image part. So, bending moment Mx is equals to in the region of 0 to L by 2, Mx is equals to WL by 4 into x minus half of 2, half into x 2 Wx by L, x by 3, WL by 4 minus Wx cube by 3L. The variation of bending moment will be cubic. At x equals to 0, Mx is 0. At x equals to L by 2, Mx is equals to WL square by 12. In the region of L by 2 and L, the bending moment diagram will be mirror image of A to C. Then in the region of L by 2 to L, the maximum bending moment will be mirror image of AC. For maximum bending moment, the differentiation of dmx is equals to d of mx divided by dx is equals to 0, that is vx equals to 0, this particular part, or WL by 4 minus of Wx square by L is equals to 0. Then the maximum bending moment comes out to be substituting this and this, WL square by 12 is the maximum bending moment for the UDL. So this is the free body diagram, and we have this particular loading figure and shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So this will be in the form of a parabolic, and this is in the form of cubic part. Now coming to simply supported beam number case 6. A simply supported beam with a gradually varying load or uniformly varying load, unit 1 per unit length, means W1 per unit length at one end and W2 per unit length at another end. So here it is W1 per meter length and here it is W2 per meter length. So let us consider this as A point, this as B point, both are a distance at a part of L distance. So at first we will treat this problem by considering UDL of identifying W1 per unit length over the whole length and varying 0 at one end to, that is W2 minus W1 per unit length at the other end. Then superimpose the two loadings as shown here. So A point, B point, this we will consider it as W1 because of this much small length height. This is W1 and here it will be W2 minus W1 per unit length. So considering a section XX at a distance X from a left end A, simply supported beam with UDL capital W1 over a whole length, shear force Vx at 1 is equals to W1 by L divided by 2 minus W1 into X, and moment at x equals to 1, which is W1 by L into half W1 into x square. Then simply supported with GVL at a zero end there, which is W2 minus W1 at what other end gives is Vx is equals to 2, W2 minus W1 divided by 6 minus W2 minus W1 divided by 2 times L whole multiplied by x square. Moment at x is equals to 2, W2 minus W1, which is L divided by x into the bracket, and minus W2 minus W1 divided by 6 into L into x cube. So this is the part of shear force what we are going to find out for this formula. So simply we are going with the left end considerations are there, means left hand side considerations are there. Moving in the upward direction positive, coming in the downward direction negative, that's it. And rotational M momentum, so clockwise rotation plus anti-clockwise rotation minus, in that direction we are able to have this much long of bending moment equation. So this is the free body diagram first, then the particular shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Simply supported beam of case number 7. So in this part we have one more case, which is the simply supported beam of seventh case therein which is going to be acting. So in this, the particular loading is simple, that is it is having a couple rotation and a couple rotation at mid span, means a simply supported beam with a couple or a moment at a distance A from the left end. So from this end it is at A point. So reaction will be moment divided by L, reaction will be moment divided by L. So considering the equilibrium, we get that RB is minus M by L and RA is M upon L. So we have to consider in this context, summation M about A is equals to 0. So where the particular value, sorting out of the rotations and moments are there. So when we consider this summation M, A equals to 0, that time RB, this RB is acting in the rotational form. Then lesson plan is asked with the subject teacher. Then RB into L plus M is equals to 0. Here RB is equals to minus M upon L, and minus RA into L plus M equals to 0, or RA is equals to M upon L. So here it is positive RA, RB is negative part. Now consider any cross section XX which is at a distance X from left end A, and another section YY at a distance X from left end A as shown in figure. So this is one X and this is another YY axis at X distance. There are two X distances what we are going to consider. So this is the region of shear force 0 to A, which is in the X region. So we will get here shear force as M upon L and bending moment as M upon L into X. Similarly, for A to L, the X is in A to L, shear force is M upon L, bending moment is M into M divided by L into X minus M. This is the shear force diagram for this particular couple part, and this is the bending moment diagram for the particular couple part in the mid span of simply supported. Simply supported beam case number 8. So whereas in this case we are able to see that the another kind of load is acting, that is simply supported beam with an eccentric loading. P is acting with an eccentric point. So in this part we have to remember that it will have a rotational effect, as well as the point P is transferred at the mid span section. So when the beam is subjected to an eccentric load, the eccentric load is to be changed into a couple, which is equals to force into distance traveled by force is equals to P into A, and a force P therefore equivalent load diagram will be. So the equivalent load diagram is this way, because P is acting here, P will be acting considering at the mid span, and anti-clockwise rotation will be the moment is equals to P into A. So here we can see the reaction P by 2 plus PA by L, and RB as P by 2 minus PA by L. These are the reactions of the supports at the couple which is acting. So in this, the considering equilibrium, summation MA equal to 0 gives minus P into L by 2 plus PA in plus RB into L, which is equals to 0. So RB is P by 2 in minus PA by L. Then RA plus RB is equals to P gives the RA value as P by 2 plus PA by L. So considering any section XX and any section YY, which is respectively from A point as shown in this figure, X is from here to here, and one more for X, YY axis is from the start point to end point of YY axis, the X is distance. So region of 0 to X L by 2, so means somewhere here it is, this point. We get the shear force diagram, we get the bending moment. So when second X is acting here, we get the particular shear force and bending moment at this place. So this is the particular figure wherein which will be having the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Thank you. See you in the next video with shear force and bending moments.